So it is a joint work with Daniel Roberts, our co-author, with Yuri Blinkov. And with Yuri, we started to do this research in early 20s, already to apply computer algebra to the discretizations of PDEs. Okay, we go further. This is the plan of my work. I skip. So we use a finite difference method. Finite difference method, one of the most widely used methods of discretizations of differential equations, not only partial but even ODE. It is the first one historically, one of the common technique to use. So the idea is to construct this on some grid, but we use a regular grid. Many people, they don't like that, the regular grid, but we use it because we can apply rather powerful technique. I'll illustrate differential algebra and difference algebra algorithmically. You can apply only for the regular grids. So we're really forced to do this. So it will be uniform and dimensional with different mesh steps, but uniform orthogonal grid. So first requirement to any discretization is just convergence. If we solve some problem numerically, say PDE plus boundary or initial value problem or mixed problems, we have mathematically it is very important to that in practice it is very difficult to prove convergence. Convergence has been proved only for a single equation. And for linear equation, for initial value problem, it is a Lux Riechmeier. Peter Lux proved that, Riechmeier also. So for Navier-Stokes, there's no chance to prove any. Even you will see. So that's why we use this empirical rule. The convergence is provided by consistency and stability, two requirements, consistency and stability. Everybody believes that it is sufficient to have convergence. So what about computer algebra? First, we started with Yuri and with Vladimir Mozhilkin, one of the professors of Saratov University. In 2006, we published our paper to design an algorithm to generate automatically the finite difference approximations, given PhD, to generate. So we done in 2006. It was a conference also Vladimir Kornyakov attended. It was a conference in Kyiv that time. It was a big conference on symmetry of regular conference on symmetry analysis of differential equations. So then computer algebra may be used not only to generate the scheme, but also to compute, to check consistency. I'll say some words about that, and to control accuracy. Also, Ganja Voroshtsov in their book, 1996, they have a special chapters on that. Also, Viktor Lewandowski with Bert Martin, 2012, published a paper only to check stability, only in the case of systems of PDEs, linear with constant coefficients. So stability is very, very non-trivial issue in this. Also applicable only for very simple cases. So now, this is six basic requirements. Already I said about convergence, consistency, stability, then conservativity we shall use. It is very important. So if a scheme inherits at the discrete level of conservation laws and symmetries, symmetry issues. Also positivity and boundedness is also very important, because if some quantities like, say, density or temperature, absolute temperature, must be positive. if you solve numerically, you have some strange behavior. Sometimes numerical value may go become negative. It is unacceptable. From physical point of view, it must be always also some strange spurious Wiggles oscillations you may get. So all these are very important. Very important. So, and then the challenging problem I'll discuss. Given PDE to construct such approximation, which inherits at the discrete level, first it must be really approximation of PDE. Second, it has to inherit basic algebraic properties of the PDE, including conservation law, symmetries, topology, maximum principle, many, many other things. So it's all so-called mimetic FDA, mimetic, which inherits. It's very, very, very important issue because in practice, I give this reference. It is big, you see, it's about 500 pages, papers, which demonstrate experimentally that if you have such schemes, it is really most of them demonstrate that if you provide these properties, so you produce highly accurate and stable numerical results. So if you really are able to inherit at discrete level basic algebraic properties of partial differential equations. So with Daniel, we started in 2010 to apply the idea of strong consistency. Strong consistency, we strengthen the consistency condition. It is any S consistent discretization is also consistent, but not vice versa. Vice versa may be not true. So then I extended, it was for linear PDEs, then I extended in 2012 to nonlinear PDEs with Daniel. Last year at the ISAC meeting, we published a paper about we applied the Thomas decomposition, difference Thomas decomposition for this analysis. And in our this year with Yuri, actually I presented a chapter of this article. It is in the archive. It is about 50 pages, so about this all this business. So the concept of strong consistency, how to verify it. And what is this? Loosely speaking, informally, what is it, does it mean S consistency? It means that if you have a system of PDEs of polynomial type, of course, polynomial type, then it generates differential ideal. All the consequences of these systems are members of the ideal. This means all of them elements vanish on the common solutions of our system. So you have differential ideal, then you discretize. You have similar difference ideal, and they are really correlated. You can imagine infinitely many consequences, then infinitely many difference consequences of our discretization. It means that any element of the difference ideal approximates a certain element of the differential ideal. So these very strong requirements, but we can verify it algorithmically nowadays because of differential and difference algebra. Then I go, let us go to Navier-Stokes equations. I'll consider incompressible with a constant density. It is, you see, a system of nonlinear, quadratically nonlinear system, three-dimensional case. I consider U is a vector of velocities, local velocities of the liquid. Then P is a pressure. X is the vector of Cartesian coordinates. Also, this is Laplace operator. Very important parameter. Parameter is just the Reynolds number. Everything depends on that. Big Reynolds number, you have turbulence, intermediate, low Reynolds number, you have laminar flow. So it is very sensitive. It is this. Now I just use the vector notations. It is shorter. Vector notations for the Navier-Stokes equations. We have this system. Okay. But now I write it first. It is our philosophy with Yuri. The first, our paper was first. If you can first rewrite your system into the conservation law form, you have to do that. And our first step of our algorithm is just to use the conservation law form whenever it is possible. Then our second step was to reformulate in the integral form, integral conservation law form. But here I won't use it. We don't use it. So I rewrite, so you can see here is divergence. D1, D2 is this. Velocities are in the divergent form. It is very important. I'll say it is conservative form. Okay, now just rewritten. Okay, now the next step in our also, one of the steps in our approach, if you can, you have to complete to involution. Complete to involution means you have to prolong to differentiate your system. We assume some smooth solutions. We assume that our function can be differentiated some number of times we really need. In principle, C infinity. We have to speak about smooth solutions. So, and then look here. If you use, I shortly, because it's technique, shortly, if I differentiate, if I have, it is a Grobner basis, differential Grobner basis computation. I have this ranking, some ordering on the derivatives. Doesn't work, okay. So this is ranking first, orderly ranking. First, I compare the orders of the derivations. In the case of the same order, I compare these dependent variables. The pressure is greater than u, x coordinates of the velocities, and so on. Then I differentiate the f0, the continuity equation. This is the first equation f0 is just the continuity equation, conservation of mass law. So then if I differentiate f0 and then I reduce model the three other equations here, it is the momentum equation, x momentum, y momentum, and that momentum of the liquid. So if you do that, we obtain this consequence. But this is a so-called Pressure-Poisson equation. This means that every solution of the Navier-Stokes equation, smooth solution, must satisfy to this. This is, for numerical analysis, it is very important point, because you have to compute numerically pressure just as a solution of this equation. From the momentum equation, you compute velocities, as we do numerically. Later, I'll tell you about numerical. This is integrability conditions. So, and it can have this form in terms of the original equations. F4 is just this. And I should say that also it is symmetric. So at the moment, if we use this one and we compute this, we preserve the symmetry under permutation. You may permute velocities, if you permute the coordinates, so we really try to preserve all the symmetry we can do, preserve. Then you will see numerically. Now I go to one of the millennium problems. It is the six millennium problems. One of them was solved by Perelman, you know, everybody here in Petersburg. Also, this millennium problem also was formulated. I'll tell this outstanding mathematician, Olga Alexandrovna Ladyzhenskaya, she proved very fundamental results. She died in 2004, but we met here once in my life, and I'm happy to talk to him. It was 2000, when it was the jubileum conference of Sofia Kovalevskaya. She was there. So I'll tell. So this is the millennium problem, number six. What is that? I a little bit slightly rewrite the problem, because the problem, again, I cannot. So the problem included the Navier-Stokes equations, but I added the Poisson pressure equation, because the millennium problem says about the smooth, about this solution of Navier-Stokes equation. So the millennium is problem is to prove the existence and smoothness of the solutions to the first two equations here. But I added the third one because if the smooth solution exists, also it satisfies, as I said, to the Poisson pressure equation. For numerical analysis, as I said already, it is very important. So, and we consider also it is a Cauchy problem. Cauchy problem. So the problem is to prove the existence and solution of and smooth the existence of the smooth solution of the Navier-Stokes equations, which satisfy two initial conditions, but very important requirement, and with a finite energy. It is a bounded energy. I'll demonstrate you one solution which doesn't satisfy so this. Three-dimensional case, just only three-dimensional case. Just two-dimensional case was investigated by Ladyzhinskaya. She proved that it is valid for the two-dimensional case. But three-dimensional case is an open problem. But why it is difficult? It's a good question. Why this problem? At the first glance, it is not so difficult equation. Quadratically nonlinear, slightly nonlinear. But the problem is, even we don't know. At the moment, we know only couple of exact solutions, but they do not satisfy to this condition. The exact solutions, we know, it's very difficult to find any exact solutions of. I mean, exact non-stationary solutions. So it is very, why difficult? Because it is extremely sensitive, the solution, sensitive to the boundary of initial value problem. If you slightly, very change initial value of boundary value problem, you change the solution. So the world of solutions, I mean, in real life, you see so great variety of liquid flow of water phenomena. It is absolutely no hope to find non-trivial, interesting, exact solutions. But even to prove the existence of smooth solution, it is a millennium problem. Because of the strong dependence on the initial and boundary value problems. That's why we decided not to attack this problem. It is no. But to do the following, trying to discretize the Navier-Stokes equations, to provide conservation of the basic algebraic properties, not all of them, but we try to do our best to do that. And then on the numerical level, we may at least locally can we investigate some smoothness of solutions of the any boundary and any, say, initial value problem. We give some example of this problem. For you, we could numerically, locally, to check smoothness, at least smoothness. But we have no chance numerically to check this condition. Okay, let us see. So two-dimensional case. Now I am going to the discretization. So we use again the homogeneous regular grid. We use again the Navier-Stokes equations. We can discretize the continuity equation and the momentum equation. This discretization, for example, finite difference is a forward shift operator along the x, say x, y, and z. This is the discretization of partial derivatives here for the Laplace operation. But we may replay for any, look here, any d, we may take any accuracy, not the second order, the accuracy approximation, any. It is a whole big class of equations, numerical equation. So good, so you good here. And then at the moment, we forget about the Poisson pressure equation, but we derive a difference analog. As soon as we fix discretization of the Navier-Stokes equation, then we apply difference algebra to obtain the integrability, the analog of the Poisson pressure equation. Here, we again select some ranking and similar derivative, similar ranking, difference ranking. Then we have this equation. This is Poisson pressure equation, which is correlated with the derivatives. Look here. It is a double, it is scalar product of two vectors which discretize partial derivatives. So it is very difficult if you try to discretize, I didn't say. So if you discretize the Poisson pressure equation, if you take the Navier-Stokes plus Poisson pressure, you discretize, it will be not a good idea because it is overdetermined system. I should go back and to stress again here. One is overdetermined system. This means four functions, three components, velocities of the liquid and pressure. And we have five equations. So you have to be careful how to solve it. If you solve, say, for example, we suggest the momentum and the Poisson pressure to use, we suggest numerically to find pressure and the components, but we have to provide. We forgot at the moment about the continuity equation. But the solution must satisfy to continuity equation. It is a mass conservation. If you solve it improperly, you destroy. Yet to our knowledge, every numerical method up to now, which was used, it destroys. You have to check at every step on numerical analysis, you have to check. If the continuity equation holds, it's fine. If not, you have to correct it. There are special big business predictor correction formula. So, but you will see how does it work our approach. So we derive this also by difference algebra. I omit computations. So, and we obtain this. Look here. This we obtain this. No. This the next one. This Poisson pressure equation. Look here. One interesting thing. Delta 3 and d commute, and du is zero if you apply the continuity equation. But since we do not use it in our numerical, we preserve this form of the Poisson pressure equation. Yes, right here. In the literature, people who use it numerically, they use a kind of this. Even this one, it is not, because almost nobody used difference algebra to do that. So here, d to d, this is special discretization of the Laplace operator. Okay. So now, it's our first result. We claim that this is our discretization. Look here, F4. By using this difference algebra, we obtain this form of the Poisson pressure equation. If we use previously, it is this Poisson pressure equation if we start with not the conservative form. But we prefer to use this, the above it is conservative form, divergence terms, conservative form. Then F4, it is a consequence of this equation. So we have five equations in four unknowns. So it is, we checked, it is strongly consistent. So the correspondence between ideals, differential and difference ideal, this correspondence holds. This is our new scheme. We have not used it yet for numerical simulation because it is a hard job, but with Yuri, we tried to simulate it. At the moment I forget, I'll present you the result of simulation of two-dimensional Navier-Stokes. It is also a very hard job, but it is a new scheme. It is our next topic to simulate it, to check it. Now let's go to the two-dimensional Navier-Stokes, and we have it is the only known exact solution for the two-dimensional Navier-Stokes, not stationary. It was discovered in 1923 by Taylor. It is so-called Taylor decay problem. It is one of the benchmarks for any discretization. It is an exact solution. You see this exponent t, exponential dependence on time, so it is decreasing. But if you fix t, if you take the u squared plus v squared plus p squared, and then integrate over the infinite domain, it is infinite. So it is not, it doesn't have a finite energy. So, okay, we took this as a benchmark. We already used it with Yuri and also with our Italian colleagues, Roberto Lascalle and Pierluigi Amudio. We already designed this scheme. And the scheme, previous scheme, it is three-dimensional, but it's two-dimensional analog. We already obtained in this paper. But we didn't, how to say, we used Roberto written some code to compute different Groebner bases to derive this Heron, but it is difficult. Nobody implemented properly the difference, nonlinear difference Groebner bases. No software at the moment. But Roberto used some tricks by using some pure polynomial implementation of the Groebner bases with some degree bound for the elements. And we obtained that. We already observed that the scheme is very good in comparison with other schemes. But I'll give you some simulation, and you will see how good it. Now we use this approximation. Oh, okay, I have time. So we use an explicit scheme. It's just the forward shift in time, central shift in the special coordinates, two-dimensional. So we have two coordinates, x and y. We have this for the Laplace operator. Laplace operator we use here, I'll write you. Just this is a two-dimensional analog of our three-dimensional scheme. This is number one. So this for delta 2 I showed you. So we have this one. But look here, to simulate, it is our two-dimensional scheme actually derived in 2017, as I said. But we compare with some other schemes. For example, this scheme we used in our paper also 2017. It is not strongly consistent, first. This is strongly consistent, conservative. And we shall see how does it work. So this is, look, because here is, you see, here is Poisson pressure, this discretization of the Laplace operator for pressure, which is strongly consistent with this one, this other. This is just naive, straightforward discretization of the Laplace operator with everybody, because it is a compact stencil, everybody would use it. Instead of this strange combination. It is double nodes. It is not so compact stencil. But it is strongly consistent. This is not strongly consistent. It is shorter, very much better numerically to use. I mean, much better, faster. Then we took this scheme. This scheme is like our scheme, this one. But this term is omitted because formally d1 commutes with delta 2, d1u is 0 by the above. d1u plus d2v is 0. So if you simplify mathematically this equation, modulo f0, you obtain this is 0, but you should not do that. numerically, algebraically, it is absolutely correct, but numerically it is bad. You will see. So the next one, as I said, we omitted that term. This one, we took non-conservative discretization of Navier-Stokes, but preserving this term. But we forgot about divergence form. So this is non-conservative. So we have these four schemes. Now I go to numerical result. So it is just common. I said you. So FD2, as I said, it is not strongly consistent. We may check it. All other schemes, three schemes, are strongly consistent, except one. But only one, the first one, is conservative, strongly consistent, and keeping the last term. Now, we took this exact solution as a benchmark. We use this domain for simulation, numerical domain. So the Reynolds number, we chosen 100, some intermediate value. Not big, not one. So we use this time step as a 0.05 times h. It provides stability, numerical stability, experimental stability. Theoretically, we cannot investigate stability. So, and now we compute, this is error. We compute error. This our numerical result. It's the exact solution. It's the grid points. We take the maximal error, and we use this formula for the Frobenius method for the error. So what we do? It's one thing. We do not use the continuity equation to construct the solution, but we use it only on the body. Because we start with initial value problem, at the initial value, it is valid. Then we forget about continuity equation. It is the only scheme, believe me, nobody done that. For example, in our very famous scheme, which is absolutely widely used, it is so-called marker and cell scheme. They correct at every step. They correct this after every shift. In time, they correct this continuity equation. But we forget about it at the moment. So we use this. This is for continuity equation, our error. Now, let us look. Look, please. I take time. So it is our best scheme. It is the error in the velocity, with different steps. That we selected in x and y the same step, just for simplicity. We may change it, the steps. The grid steps are the same because it is symmetric with respect to x, y, so it is reasonable to do. So h. H here is 0.1. We have 10 to minus, look here, 10 to minus 4. It is logarithmic scale, 10 to minus 4. Then it is scaled if we make it twice less than twice, so it is scaled at h squared. So it is a second order term, second order in h. The truncation order, it is second order term. But look here it is 10 to minus 6. So we have error for the smallest h is 0.025, it is about 10 to minus 6. It is already much higher than h squared. But OK, it is second order scheme. It is this one. This is already worse. If you compare, for example, this one with the same scale, it is 10 to minus 3. So this is three order worse than the first scheme. So we obtain much higher accuracy first. If compare with this scheme, it is not strongly consistent. The same order of the scheme, but no consistency, three order in value, we lose. Okay, now this one, As I said, it is strongly consistent, but with the omitted the last term. The last term. It is unstable. You see, it is at the beginning it has the same order of value, but it is growing up. So stability doesn't hold. But in the last one scheme, it is strongly consistent. It is we included the last term, but it is not conservative. This is 10 to minus 4. It is two order of value worse than the first scheme, 100 times. So you see, our comparison with the scheme shows at least in two orders of value, the first scheme is better than the others, even higher. But it is one thing. But the most impressive result, we do not. We were really, I show you the next picture. Look here. As I said, we forgotten about the continuity equation. It is conservation law, but we may measure it. We computed, I shown you the Frobenius formula. Now, no, it's our, sorry, this one. It is FDA1. I shown already FDA1. Now this is, look here, it is 10 to minus 11. So our conservation law holds up to the order without controlling it, 10 to minus 10. It is absolutely strange, absolutely unbelievable, because our scheme is second order. You wouldn't expect that something would be better. The conservation law, we didn't control. The conservation law holds. It is still a big, exciting for us, but we have to understand that. So look here. Here is a sixth order in value, sixth order, 1 million times. So the previously, this is FDA4. Is worse, but so it is increasing like any numerical scheme if you take smaller and smaller steps up to certain, say, taking very smaller, but finally you will have some increase because the numerical, you cannot improve up to infinity the numerical. So it is growing up, but it is much, so it is. We try to find in the literature no such schemes which would preserve the conservation law with so high accuracy. So, sorry, I have to already. So now I go to conclusion. So for the three-dimensional, first we derived the three-dimensional scheme. We have to test it, of course. Test it on the real benchmarks. Now, as a benchmarks, we select a three-dimensional analog of this exact solution, it exists. But recently, I discovered a new exact solution obtained in Institute of Physics and Technology in Moscow. It was a sensation for us. It is a new, the second. Before 27, it was just a single exact solution. People found a new exact solution. We should check there also. Yuri is the main person who doing our numerical analysis. So we should check the three dimensional. But up to now, we combined first to derive three-dimensional scheme. We combined methods of differential and difference Grobner basis. So the obtained scheme, say, allows that. What is good? Now we may forget about at least at the two-dimensional level. We forget about the continuity equation. It's very convenient to solve Poisson pressure, to find from the Poisson pressure equation, the velocities from the momentum equation, and with so high accuracy. So holding the continuity equation. So it is so-called the primitive variables. It is most natural. Also, the Millennium problem is formulated exactly in terms of the velocities and pressure. There are other formulations, for example, flux and vorticity, especially to check turbulence. So we use this two-dimensional version as a benchmark, we computed numerical experiments, and this is very interesting. So the continuity question holds with much higher accuracy, much, much higher accuracy than the scheme truncation error. So we have a lot of stuff to understand, but it is really strange. But the way Yuri made also interesting analysis of this behavior, the table. I didn't show you the table, how the, if you take the fractions of the h, if h goes to zero, you compute the error. Here it's good, but you compute the errors. So all other schemes at the certain level, the saturation of the errors numerical. If you decrease at certain level, you cannot increase further, as I said, the errors, except our scheme. Our scheme scales with respect to the H quite nicely. Okay, so time is over.
Thank
we
you.
May discuss.
Actually, the time is not over, but we need to save at least 5
yes.
minutes
for discussion, for questions. Please, even in Russian.
First time, at first we have to thank for very interesting presentation. And just now,
please, please, yeah.
Question of Olga.
Oh, Sasha, yes.
Maybe in English.
Yeah, I may go back to any slide. Okay. No problem.
So you can.
Which one? Go back. This
here.
One.
Maybe you construct such a kind of symplectic integrator, because you have
perhaps
a
yes.
dimensional Hamiltonian system, and with a function, this law of energy conservation is quadratic form in phase variables, no?
No. We didn't check in that sense. We just maybe it's a kind of symplectic integrator,
but in this case, not only energy plays the role, but other integrals. Because
sure.
Symplectic structure. If you try to keep the energy, it is not even symplectic,
yes.
but not.
Нет, мы не делали ничего. Мы просто прополучили схему и стараясь то учесть все, что мы можем.
But it's very interesting effect. Maybe the scheme of constructing discretization due to some algebraic qualities allow us maybe not only keep the integrals, but keep some additional structure.
But
in this case, it can be not symplectic structure, but some structure with allow us to keep the values of concrete integrals.
Yes, because you see, it's strange, really strange. I would be happy to have any integral of motion, whatever, which would valid up to the order of the scheme. But it is much higher, the order of the scheme. So we shall wait for the three-dimensional case. It is really for the three-dimensional case, we shall see. I hope the scheme will work also nicely, but only experiment will show.
Other questions?
Maybe other questions?
And one
Yuri,
one
you
one
may
one
say
short,
something.
Short comment, because I want to say that maybe last year, and we discussed with Vladimir the way to discretize such kind of the system, which would be keep some structure, the set yes. of integrals, and maybe another structure like symplectic integrators with which keep this symplectic structure and symplectic volume and energy and so on. And I am sure that this effect is due to some algebraic.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
Absolutely. Qualities of discretization procedure.
For example, it's hardly unbelievable that we only, you see, at the border, we only fix this continuity equation on the border. T equal to zero, then it is preserved. If you would have another exact solution, we could try, but for the three-dimensional case, we have at least two different exact solutions. And the second exact solution of three-dimensional, it doesn't have a two-dimensional analog. We shall see. If it again, it will be preserved. That should be investigated further, rigorously.